What we did in this study is we identified families that had large numbers of resilient individuals and then looked for the DNA that those resilient people share with each other that they don't share with their loved ones who died of Alzheimer's disease. We identified a family that had four individuals who were elderly and carried genetic risk for Alzheimer's disease, but were cognitively healthy. And we identified a rare genetic change that was shared among all the resilient people, and also shows evidence of protection against Alzheimer's disease in multiple independent data sets. So this is really exciting.
We said instead of figuring out why people get disease, we want to focus on individuals that should have disease but don't, and figure out what genetics they have that are protecting them against Alzheimer's disease. And employing this approach, we were able to find this RAB10 variant.
We had the good fortune of being able to work with the Utah Population Database, which is the LDS Church's genealogical records combined with the state of Utah's medical records and with the Cache County study on memory and aging.
The Utah Population Database is very large, has multiple generations worth of data, so it allows us to look at these discoveries we make and determine whether or not they're real.
So this is a very large family with lots of individuals who are resilient and lots of individuals who died of Alzheimer's disease, and that gives us the proper context to conduct our research. All the individuals that we found in our initial family carry both the APOE4 gene, which is a risk factor for Alzheimer's disease, and this RAB10 variant that protects from disease. And so even though they have vastly elevated risk from the E4 allele, they actually have much lower risk for disease if they carry our variant, even in the face of that risk. So we've really worked hard to develop the biological mechanism by which this genetic variant actually impacts Alzheimer's disease. There are companies that are currently negotiating with BYU to use this and develop it into a therapeutic intervention.
The goal of our study was to find genetic variants that protect individuals from Alzheimer's disease. And I think the most important takeaway from this particular study is that they do in fact exist.
The discoveries we're reporting in this manuscript provide a new target with a new mechanism that we believe has great potential to impact Alzheimer's disease in the future.